say cold start, I don't mean having it sit overnight in the springtime, and then in the morning when it hits 60 degrees, it's tough. I mean cold start, like it's 28 degrees out, and the bike was sitting in this little thing for 2-3 days, so it's cold. But I tried starting earlier, I did plugs, I did oil change, and after the iridium plugs, I was like, let me fire it up, make sure all is well. And after 10 minutes, it just wasn't firing up, and I said, screw it, I don't want to flood it. I went to go get my hair cut, I came back, the thing fired up right away. Go figure. The only thing I changed was I plugged it into the trickle charger in that 45-minute time period, and the battery, I guess, charged more, and I took off the kickstand when I started it. That shouldn't make a difference, but the only other thing I could think of that made a difference was putting the battery on the trickle charger. Now, this makes me think, is there a battery problem? Because when I started, without the trickle charger, it starts the engine, and it'll catch, and it'll hit 1,000, 1,500 RPM, but it'll die pretty much 2-3 seconds. I keep trying it, and I keep trying it, and eventually the thing gets going. So like I said, I gave it a break for 30 minutes, 45 minutes, I came back with a trickle charger, it started up right away. Fresh gas, just drained the old gas, because I had a full can of barium into B12, which is obviously too much to put in, like 4 gallons of gas. So I drained it all, I put fresh gas, and another thing to mention is, when I start this, to show, I barely have to activate it. I could put it at like 25% and the bike fires up, and I can shut it off right away and it won't stall out, the bike won't die. It's like the choke doesn't do anything. And I verified the choke cable is working, it is opening the valve, I see it moving. I just don't understand. Another thing I have to do, physically sounds and runs good. It's just getting it to start over. Those cold starts absolutely suck.